Hi friends, I am Dr. Govind Narayan Purohit, the former professor and head, Department of Veterinary Gynecology and Obstetrics, College of Veterinary and Animal Sciences, Rajasthan University of Veterinary and Animal Sciences, Bikaner, Rajasthan, India. Friends, I welcome you to my YouTube channel, Govind Narayan Purohit, wherein we are discussing the different topics of veterinary gynecology, obstetrics and andrology. And in our today's talk, I try to discuss something about the mechanisms of puberty. Now, first of all, let us talk about what is puberty. Puberty is the age at which the female or the male gonads become capable of releasing the gametes, the oocytes in the female or the spermatozoa in the male. Puberty is a life-changing event and it is characterized by the first oestrus in the females, and it is characterized by appearance of sperms in the ejaculate of the males, and also the changes in the behavior of the male and the female as well, which we will be talking later. Now, we want to talk something about another term which comes with puberty, and that is sexual maturity. Sexual maturity is not the same as puberty, because sexual maturity is attaining the full reproductive capacity, which is attained sometime later after puberty, maybe a few weeks or a few months after puberty, the female or the male, it attains the sexual maturity. Now, puberty is known to be affected by a lot of things, the species, the breed, maybe the Holstein Friesian, they have a puberty at a lower age as compared to the Rathi or as compared to other breeds, indigenous breeds, which have a higher age at puberty. If we talk of the buffalo heifers, the age at puberty is much more, 42 to 48 months in most buffalo heifers. And then puberty is also largely affected by the nutrition. Now, the key regulator of puberty, both in the male and the female animals, is the GnRH. The release of GnRH from the preoptic area, or maybe the median eminence, basically it is the median eminence, the increased secretions of GnRH affects the pituitary. It reaches the pituitary by hypothalamo-hypophyseal portal system and affects the secretion of two gonadotropins. Gonadotropins, as you know, are the hormones which have a trophic effect on the gonads. LH and FSH secretions are affected, and they affect the steroidogenesis by the ovary as well as the testes of the male. And the ovaries produce estrogen and progesterone, and the testes produce another androgen, that is testosterone. Now, the males, they do not have a surge center. The secretion of GnRH is of two types, as we have talked in a previous class on hormones, and then there is a surge-like release. The surge-like release is absent, or is absent in the male animals, because they do not require any mechanism such as ovulation. Then the surge centers are developed after puberty, and this leads to pre-ovulatory surge of luteinizing hormone, which causes ovulation in the heifers, and this rhythmically then continues. The GnRH secretions do occur before puberty, but of low pulses are there, and the amplitude is also low. Now, what are the potential regulators of GnRH pulses at puberty? The development of the surge center leads to surge-like release from the GnRH and changes in the feedback sensitivity to estradiol in ruminant species. Now, there is one theory for attainment of puberty, it's an old theory, which is known as the Gonadostat theory, that there is decrease in the negative feedback of estrogens in association with pubertal increase in GnRH. See, the ovaries are producing estrogens even before puberty, but they will have a negative effect on the secretion of GnRH at the pre-optic area. But as puberty is obtained, the negative feedback of estrogens is reduced, and this is known as the Gonadostat theory. Now, this is one of the oldest theory, and as you can see in this chart, the prepubertal secretion of small amounts of steroids have a negative effect on the GnRH secretion, but post puberty they will have a positive effect on the GnRH secretion. Now, in this chart, I have made this personally, and I have gathered information from a lot of published documents and tried to explain in brief the operative mechanisms for puberty. The basic regulator of GnRH secretion appears to be the Kisspeptin neurons located in the arcuate nucleus. This Kisspeptin neurons are stimulated by the KNDY neurons. The KNDY neurons are stimulated by a peptide neurokinin B, and they are downregulated by dynorphin A. The dynorphin A downregulates the KIS1 gene expression, whereas the KNDY neurons, when stimulated by neurokinin B through the glial cells and increased calcium channels, cause increased expression of KIS1 gene. This results into Kisspeptin pulses, and Kisspeptin neurons are stimulated. The Kisspeptin neurons then bind with the GPR54 receptor on the GnRH neurons in the median eminence and stimulate the release of GnRH pulses. Also, the propiomelanocortin neurons, they also have a role in stimulating the Kisspeptin neurons. Besides that, the nutrition, the environment, the epigenetic cues, and the metabolic cues, they also have a role in the Kisspeptin stimulation. The leptins and insulin, leptins are present in the adipose tissue, and insulin, they have positive roles on the Kisspeptin neuron stimulation, whereas ghrelin, which is secreted from the stomach, has a negative role on Kisspeptin stimulation. The energy balance, the pancreas, liver, and the body weight of the animal, they have a complex interplay in regulating the Kisspeptin neurons. Then, before puberty, the inhibitors in the sheep and rodents are the estrogens, whereas the gamma aminobutyric acid GABA and neuropeptide Y are the inhibitors in the primates. So, when Kisspeptin secretion is stimulated, the GnRH secretion is stimulated. Increased GnRH causes increased gonadotropin secretion. This stimulates the follicles in the ovary, which secrete estrogen, and the animal starts coming into estrus. So, this is in brief or in nutshell the information related to mechanisms of puberty, which I have made from by gathering information from different documents. But I have personally made this. Then, as I mentioned earlier, the prepubertal period, ovarian estrogens have a negative role on the KNDY neurons and the GnRH neurons, but post puberty they have a stimulatory role on the KNDY and the GnRH neurons. In the primate species, the GABA and the neuropeptide Y neurons, they have roles on they have a negative role before puberty and a positive role after puberty. Then nutrition has impact on the onset of puberty. Heifers that are well fed return to attain puberty at a lower age, but heifers that are malnourished will have puberty later. They will have puberty very late. So in villages where the nutrition is not optimum, the heifers will have delayed puberty, and this is because of the effects of nutrition on the onset of puberty in the female animals. Now you can see here the liver, the pancreas secreting insulin, the glucose and the adipose tissue which secretes leptins, they all have regulatory roles, direct or indirect regulatory roles on the onset of puberty. Now this shows that the prenatal and early postnatal nutrition, how it affects the puberty. You see, adequate prenatal and early postnatal nutrition leads to reduced neuropeptide Y tone, increased POMC tone, differential DNA methylation, increased GnRH and LH pulse frequency, advanced pubertal maturation. But metabolic signals influence the GnRH secretion. Say prepubertal starvation, it leads to the negative effects on the KIS peptins, and the GnRH secretion as well. The leptins, low levels of leptins and neuropeptide Y also have the low blood glucose, have negative effects on the KIS peptin neurons and then ultimately GnRH neurons and the GnRH secretion. Whereas after puberty or better nutrition, this results into the better GnRH secretion and earlier puberty. So here you can see the effects or the changes in the estradiol has a negative feedback during the prepubertal, and this is decreasing during the peripubertal period, but it has a positive role after puberty. GnRH secretion pulse frequencies are more after puberty, but they are low during the prepubertal and peripubertal period. LH secretion also, the LH surge, it occurs only after puberty, and the follicle before puberty never reaches the ovulatory size. Now, during the first estrus in heifers is of short duration because there is no progesterone, and the first ovulation is not synonymous with puberty in most heifers. Also, the first luteal phase is usually of short duration due to abundance of endometrial oxytocin receptors because of lack of progesterone. So prostaglandin is released early and heifers return to estrus very early. But after that, and in this picture you can see that the growth rate, in this table you can see the growth rate is enhanced after puberty, because after puberty estrogen secretion is regular and estrogen has a anabolic effect. The estrogens have anabolic effect, so they help in weight gain. You can see here the weight at breeding 360 to 400 kg in Holstein Brown Swiss heifers, and at calving at the age of 23 to 25 months, the weight is increased substantially. So the puberty has a positive role in the weight gain. Now there are some behavioral changes in after puberty in heifers. Some of the heifers may develop small udders over here, and this is because of the hormone changes that do occur, the estrogen and progesterone. And sometimes people may be confused that the heifer is pregnant, but simply the development of a udder in the heifer is not suggestive that it is pregnant. In the male animals, that will there will be development of a prominent hum and a hoarse voice. So friends, if you like this lecture, give your likes, give your comments, give your suggestions, and share and subscribe to my channel, Govind Narayan Purohit. You can contact me at my email gnpobs@gmail.com, and you can give your suggestions on my lecture, and you can download the PDF of this lecture directly by clicking on the link given in the description of this video. So thank you. So thanks for your listening. Have a nice day. Bye bye. See you in the next video. Thank you.